God, just to...
Oh, no!
Perfect!
Cheers.
Cheers.
So, very... welcome. Be a good partner.
Do I continue or do I stop my career or, like, what's next? Episode number 4, I guess. Today, I'm going to introduce you to my new skating partner. She's a little bit shy. Let me just... Isn't she cute? New skating partner. Welcome, everybody. Miss Olivia Smart.
Hello. Hello, everybody. Hi.
So we thought just to...
Oh, no!
Perfect. Set up crashed right away.
Smooth. I'm less cute than Stella, though.
Yeah, we thought about, like, just doing, like, a small interview-ish introduction thing to our new partnership. Here we are on a very, very nice day after skating, Friday. Wine. Yeah.
I think I just spilled water down first. Me as well.
Cheers.
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 Cheers to our new partnership and introducing myself to all of you and new adventures, eh?
Yes.
I've already made a mess. I've been in here for 2 minutes and I've spilt the drinks. I've spilt stuff down me. Just be careful on the white pillows. As Tim already knows, this is a very wholesome partnership. We have a lot of fun together. I am a walking comedy show.
She is. We have so much fun on the ice, like every day. Even if there are times like, okay, oh, Friday, it's like a hard day, but we have, like, exactly today, we had, like, the best day to finish the week. So we have so much fun. Skating is going great, but I'm saying, like, look back already, but it's only been, like, what? How long are we here for now?
We're end of May, so, what, we're on it, like, a month, month and a half?
Yeah.
We skated a bit together before that, but this is our first, like, month, month and a half in Montreal, training with IAM, all of our training mates. Tim getting used to Montreal and finding a place here and calling it his new home for a bit.
It's so very...
welcome. We've already said it, but now you're actually seeing it. Tim's getting used to Montreal. As you've seen on his other episodes, he's adventuring.
Montreal, episode 3. Here we go.
And trying new things. He's doing more than I have, and I've been here for what, 8-9 years now? So I think I need to step up my game.
I'm getting there.
Also, to clarify, Stella is also Tim's partner if I'm ever away. But these are not my dogs. This is Henry and Stella. This is Maddie, Chalk, and Evan Bates' dogs. Say hi to Mommy and Daddy. They're currently on tour in the US, I think. So I get the pleasure to watch them. But these are not my babies.
And I love dogs anyway, so...
Perfect. Sorry, she took your seat.
Yeah,
she did. Come here, give him some space. Be a good partner. And
be a good partner.
Good girl.
Yeah, like Montreal now, and it all started back in October last year.
Yeah, officially October. Well, officially, that's when we first skated together in October. Yeah, it was unexpected. When Tim asked me for a tryout, I was interested, but it was also a time in my life and my career where I wasn't sure what I was doing. I didn't know whether I was going to continue skating. I was trying new things. I was trying to push myself out of my comfort zone than skating. And I was really enjoying it and pushing myself. So I really wasn't sure if I was going to continue skating. So I didn't want Tim to come all the way here to Montreal to have a tryout with me when I wasn't even sure what I was doing. So I did say to Tim that I was interested. And then, as bad as it sounds, about what, 2 or 3 weeks later, I turned around and unfortunately declined because I was just not in the headspace and where I was with my life to do a tryout. Even though I was interested, I just didn't have the capacity for it then. So then that was in the summer. And then Tim came to Montreal, finally, later on in the year, in October.
So basically before she got me super excited and then very upset. And then super excited again. This is now.
Yeah, I learned from that. And hey, I'm very glad he came. And I'll tell you the story, but very grateful it all happened the way it did. Also, it's a fun story.
Yeah.
So yeah, I got his hopes up, ended up crushing his hopes and dreams. And then Tim ended up coming to Montreal in October anyway to have a tryout, or a few tryouts in Montreal, because we had a few people that wanted partners and stuff. And at the time I was helping out IAM with a little bit of coaching, a little bit of just learning things that I could do out of training and competing. So Tim was around and I saw him, of course, but it wasn't until I had dinner with my coaches, and it was Marie France and Stephanie Hanlon, our life coach. Both of these powerful women who I adore, and they're my mentors, like, of course I'm gonna follow and listen to them. They invited me over for dinner and we were chatting, and literally the first thing they said to me as we were pouring a glass of wine was, I think you need to have a tryout with Tim. And I'm like, huh? What? Where's this come from? And they're like, he's here, we've seen him skate, he's really good, and he's a really, really good guy and really nice, and they got a good energy from him. So instantly I was like, oh gosh, okay. That was great for me to hear, but plot twist, I had just signed my contract to join Dancing on Ice literally a week prior.
Perfect timing.
So I'd already signed the contract for Dancing on Ice to leave for 6 months and do this TV show in the UK. So I was like, well, okay, but my plans have changed. They said, I know you have this new contract, everything, but just give it a try. And they didn't want me to have any regrets. And agreed that when I said yes to the tryout in the summer, it was to have no regrets. So I followed their advice as I wanted to in the summer from myself. And I said, okay, Tim, the coaches want us to have a tryout. We're gonna have a tryout. I was super nervous and wasn't sure what to expect. And of course I felt bad because I'm gonna beep at these cars as well, because they don't agree with this.
Montreal traffic light?
Yeah, we had our tryout when you were here in Montreal, and first session, we were like, oh wow, this is very good. And it feels very natural to say we're two different skaters from different schools, have learned how to skate differently, technique, whatnot. It just looked good. And for us, it felt good, but the confirmation from Marie-France, Romain, and Patrice that it looked good as well was like, okay, maybe this is something that we should do. So long story short, we took their advice. I trusted my feelings, and Tim did as well. And we knew it was a good thing and the right thing for us. And if we wanted to continue competing and skating, because it's something we love to do, this is our window of opportunity. And for me, I don't think I would have found somebody else. So Tim came at the right time, and I take that as a sign, and I'm super grateful. I personally get a second chance to do something I love and compete again. And Tim's in the same headspace. I know you just want to keep pushing yourself in the sport.
Of course, like after the Olympic Games in Beijing, it was like a hard time, like for everyone, like who was like, didn't really know, okay, what do I do? Do I continue, or do I stop my career, or like what's next? But I still felt in my heart and in my body, okay, I still want to push my limits. I still didn't feel myself okay at where I can be. It was like, okay, I mean, that's the best what I can get for sure. So I was really glad that all the coaches have been very happy with our tryout and with our like skating so far. So this helped as well. And then there was the contract thing from Olivia with Dancing on Ice, as you mentioned, which was not a big thing, because we both had to take a year off from competition.
Yeah.
That was like for sure before, like we couldn't start skating right away because it's an official rule for us. Like we have to take a 1 year break of competition before we start skating together. And so this came in time, and I actually got to visit Olivia in UK, got to see a little bit of Dancing on Ice, which was always like a big thing for me to see like what's going on there. Mm-hmm. And I mean, saw you and Nye skating there was like, I mean, if you watched it, if not, like check it out, Niall, this guy is just mind-blowing what he does after such a short time on the ice like everyone else there. So it was a very nice experience.
You got to help us a bit
as
well.
Yeah. Like one session we did together. Was it semi-final, right?
Semi-finals. Yeah, personal week. Tim was on the ice with us and helped me teach him a few lifts, tricks, knee slides, things. And it was so helpful because for me, I'm not a coach. I've never been able to explain to somebody how to do something. I'm like, can I just show you? So with Tim, I could do it. And then Niles is like a sponge. He would see something and he'd just copy it. Yeah. So it was very productive having Tim there. And also like introducing him into all of this. And gosh, you were so patient. Mm. 6 months of me being away and being busy. And I thought I would have more time during the show where we could train a bit. And you could come to the UK, we could train a bit in between the shows, et cetera, et cetera. Little did I know, this show took over my life for 6 months and I had zero extra time. So that got a little bit challenging for us. But as soon as we were done with the show, I needed a quick break. And then I knew I was going to be refreshed and like straight back to training. Gosh, and here we are, eh?
Yeah, here we are.
Six months later, like...
Time is going
so
super fast.
Yeah.
Like, especially this time, of course, like it was like a not hard time, but weird time because you didn't like, you waited for the point, okay, when is the life in Montreal starting? Because you knew, like I knew, okay, it's going to start soon, but, and I also knew when, but I was like waiting, but of course I kept myself busy a bit in Germany and it was a good time, like also like after so many years of skating and like that level and trying to push your limits, it was also kind of nice to like
take a break,
breathe a bit. But here we are now, and now we're trying to get back into shape.
Dusting off the cobwebs, our knees, our feet, everything, and we're trying to, gosh, get ourselves back into shape and trying new things, pushing ourselves again, getting our creative brain going. But it's been fun, and I wanted to say as well, it's like the coaches saw something in us when we had our tryout. We felt something. But on top of that, Tim and I have known each other for
more than 10 years.
Yeah,
I guess
10 plus years. We competed in junior together for ages, and we've always known of each other and been friends. Like we were together at the Olympics. Like there's a friendship there as well that I don't have with other people if I was to have tryouts and vice versa. So we're already comfortable with each other. We have a good time together. We're just comfortable.
Yeah, it helps a lot.
Yeah, it does help. It does. It breaks down a barrier that may have been there with somebody brand new. And like we said earlier, we have so much fun together. We get serious together. We have fun together. We push ourselves. And something that's been very valuable already in the month of us skating together is our communication.
Yeah.
Because we're both very headstrong and we know we're...
Aries.
We're both Aries.
Aries.
That helps. So, but we're both back into this sport and we're doing this again because we love the sport. We love what we do.
Yeah.
We're not doing it because we have to. We're doing it because we love it. And we have goals, we have things we want to achieve, we want to enjoy this process. So we're like, hey, how about we make this as easy and as pleasant as possible? And I've learned personally in my career prior with Adrian and through our coaches and everything that communication is key.
Yeah.
So from day one with Tim, we were just like, hey, communication, let's just be open with each other, talk about things, languaging towards each other. And look, we're not perfect, but already like we have a solid base. And
after such a short time, I mean it's been like 2 months, as we said, like in normal daily practice life, and already now like we find the right way of communication, and so far the training process is going great.
And we're able to do things like this as well.
That's
something so new to me.
Yes.
It's like I never mix like business with pleasure, but you're my friend before you're my partner. Mm. So this is all so new to me. And it's something that I can't compare from my past. So it's very special and so unexpected. So unexpected.
Yeah.
But everything happens for a reason.
Exactly. Yeah, so as I said, like, we have lots of content planned, and of course, like, now slowly, like, the season will start at some point. We are almost done with our programs. Mm-hmm. We're very excited to show you, and we feel the programs very much. That's like one of my biggest points. Like, just today I said, like, back to the coach, like, to Sam, I think it was in the session, I never skated programs which felt that comfortable, and after such a short time, it's like a big, big thing for me.
But then I keep telling him, I'm like, wait. You're saying this now. Let's wait until we, because we're really just skating the programs and dancing them and like having fun. I'm not doing clean turns right now. Are you kidding me? No, but I understand what you mean, but like, they're fun and we're having a lot of, there's a lot of space there for us to be ourselves and open, but it's gonna get.
For sure.
Like, you know.
I
get what you mean. Like, the characters in our programs and everything we're playing, like, I know you guys don't know our music yet and stuff, but they suit us really well.
Yeah.
And it's not something we had planned forever. It's just, it came up randomly and like naturally.
Super random. Like the everything in this partnership.
Everything. So super random, but when we announce it and tell everybody our music, and we'll be able to talk a bit more about the hat, but like how our free dance music came up, mm-hmm. like rhythm dance music, everything's just been so natural, and we've been just following the path that is that the things that are coming up and trusting it. And yeah, and for us, it's like, it's having no expectations during this, but we know what we want, we know what we can achieve. But like I said earlier, we're enjoying the process. It's not just we're looking far into the future, we're enjoying the steps to get there as well, which is so nice.
Yeah, we're both really looking forward to what's like next and what's to come. Season start, I mean, for a new partnership, it's always like very exciting, but super fun so far. So that's for sure gonna help. And yeah, we like, I will try as much as possible to take you throughout the process. Of course, we can't have a camera going on during daily practice, but
we
try to get it done and yeah, take you on the journey. That was the small little introduction.
I feel like we should have a fire round of questions.
Yeah.
Like, you ask me a question, I ask you a question.
Which we don't know before.
Yes,
like,
yeah.
Super random questions.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I already have my first one.
You do? Oh, perfect.
Yeah.
Cheers to that.
I already have my first question, and I'm sure people will want to hear.
So, I mean, see you in the next one then, and I hope you liked it so far. And as always, like, leave a like, subscribe, don't miss anything. And then see you in the next one.
See you
soon. Bye, everyone.
Bye.